Hello friends, today we are going to discuss regarding the perineal membrane. In my previous lectures, we have already completed this urogenital triangle up to the superficial perineal pouch, and now we are move on to perineal membrane. So for the quick revision, you can say that in this coronal section, we have the seven layers, and out of them, the first one is the skin, second one is the superficial fatty layer of the superficial fascia. The third one, that is the coulis fascia. The fourth one, it is the superficial perineal pouch. The fifth one, it is the perineal membrane. The sixth one, this is the deep perineal pouch. And the seventh layer, that is the superior layer of the urogenital diaphragm. So we are going to talk regarding this perineal membrane, and this perineal membrane, it is the membrane lies between the superficial perineal pouch below and the deep perineal pouch above. So when we see this perineal membrane in case of the pelvic outlet view, we can see that this perineal membrane, it crosses across the pubic arch and it is triangular in nature. And this is a strong sheath of the fascia, which is having a apex situated anteriorly, and this apex, it is thickened to form one ligament, and that ligament, it is called as the transverse perineal ligament. In case of male, this perineal membrane, it is very tough because of the attachment with the root of the penis as well as associated perineal muscles, which are present within the superficial perineal pouch below the perineal membrane and the deep perineal pouch above the perineal membrane. So when we see the attachment of this perineal membrane, it is on the each side, it is attached with the ischiopubic ramus inner side just above the crush of the penis, because the crush of the penis, they are situated within the superficial perineal pouch, and this perineal membrane, it lies above the superficial perineal pouch. When we see the anterior aspect of this perineal membrane that we have already discussed, this is thickened to form one ligament, and that ligament, it is the transverse perineal ligament. And the further extension of the anterior aspect of this perineal membrane, we have to see the sagittal section, and this is the sagittal section of the male pelvis, and here this membrane, it is the perineal membrane. Just above the perineal membrane, this is the deep perineal pouch, and just below it, this is the superficial perineal pouch. This perineal membrane, anteriorly, it is going to form one ligament, and that ligament, it is the transverse perineal ligament, we have already discussed, and then this perineal membrane, it is going to continue with the superior layer of the urogenital diaphragm. When we see on the posterior side, this perineal membrane, it is going to divide the superficial perineal pouch and the deep perineal pouch, and going to split into two layers. One layer passes above, and this layer, it is going to continue with the superior layer of the urogenital diaphragm, and the lower layer, it is going to continue with this coulis fascia. So we can say this perineal membrane, it is continuous anteriorly with the superior layer of the urogenital diaphragm, and posteriorly it is going to split into two layers. One layer, it is going to continue with the superior layer of the urogenital diaphragm, and the lower layer, it is going to continue with the fascia of the coulis. So we can say this deep perineal pouch, which is closed from all the sides, while the superficial perineal pouch, it is open anteriorly and closed from behind. As we already discussed, this urogenital diaphragm, it is made up of three layers: the perineal membrane, deep perineal pouch, as well as the superior layer of the urogenital diaphragm. These three are collectively called as the urogenital diaphragm, and that is the reason why the perineal membrane, it is also called as the inferior layer of the urogenital diaphragm. Now let's move on to the structures piercing the perineal membrane, and for that let's see this full view of the perineal membrane, where we have already removed the layers of the skin, superficial fatty layer, Cooley's fascia, as well as the superficial perineal pouch. And this view from the pelvic outlet, we are able to see only the perineal membrane. So in case of male, the perineal membrane, it is pierced in the midline by the urethral opening only. And this urethra, which passes through the deep perineal pouch, as we see in this coronal section, it is called as the membranous urethra. So this portion, it is the membranous urethra, which passes through the deep perineal pouch. And this membranous urethra, it is going to pierce this perineal membrane. After piercing this perineal membrane, this membranous urethra is now called as bulbar urethra. So within this section of the male, within the midline, this perineal membrane, it is pierced by this urethra. And on the each side of the urethra, in case of male, we find duct of the bulbourethral gland. And we already know that bulbourethral gland, which is present within the deep perineal pouch, and that's why the duct of the bulbourethral gland, they has to pierce the perineal membrane to come to the superficial perineal pouch, where it is going to drain into penile urethra. So here in this figure, we can appreciate that these two are the bulbourethral glands, and this bulbourethral glands, they having a duct, and they has to pass through the perineal membrane, and they has to open into the penile urethra. So this duct of the bulbourethral gland, they has to pierce the perineal membrane. Now on the each side of the duct of the bulbourethral gland, we find one arteries on each side, and these two are the small arteries, which are the branch of the internal pudendal arteries, and these are the artery to the bulb of the penis. Now in case of the male as well as female, on the base side, four structures are going to pierce the perineal membrane, and these are the branches of the perineal arteries, and these are the posterior scrotal vessels. And on the each side, there is one nerve, and these are the posterior scrotal nerve. And the orientation of this posterior scrotal nerves as well as the vessel, we have already discussed in our previous lecture. As for the quick revision, this posterior scrotal nerves as well as the vessel, they are passing through the pudendal canal and going to enter into the deep perineal pouch from the posterior side, and then these structures are going to pierce the perineal membrane to come out into the superficial perineal pouch. Now this perineal membrane is also going to be pierced on each side towards the lateral aspect of its attachment by the two vessels. One is the deep artery of the penis or clitoris, and one is the dorsal artery of the penis or the clitoris. So on the same side, this one is the dorsal artery of the penis or clitoris, and this one is the deep artery of the penis or clitoris. Now let's see the structures which are going to pierce the perineal membrane within the female. So here, this is the transverse perineal ligament, which is the anterior extension of the perineal membrane. And these are the two lateral attachments of the perineal membrane. And this perineal membrane, it is pierced by the urethral opening in front 2 to 3 centimeters behind the transverse perineal ligament. In case of female, this perineal membrane, it is also going to be pierced by the vagina, which is situated behind the urethral opening. And same like that of the male, in case of the basal side of this perineal membrane, two posterior scrotal vessels as well as the two posterior scrotal nerves, they are going to pierce the perineal membrane on each side. And just anterior towards the lateral side of the perineal membrane, this in case of female, it is pierced by the deep artery of the clitoris as well as the dorsal artery of the clitoris. So here this is also the dorsal artery of the clitoris and this is the deep artery of the clitoris. In case of female, this perineal membrane, it is not going to be pierced by the duct of the similar glands like bulbourethral glands, and in case of female, these are the greater vestibular glands, because these greater vestibular glands, they are present within the superficial perineal pouch and they do not need to pierce this perineal membrane to come out into the superficial perineal pouch. So in case of female, no other openings of the ducts of the any glands present which are going to pierce the perineal membrane. In case of the female, this posterior scrotal vessels and the nerves, they are termed as posterior labial nerves and the vessels. So this is all about the perineal membrane.